Hi, so in this video, we're gonna be taking a look at the better version of OpenBoardView, which is numbered 8.95.0. And this better version includes some new features, such as you can see here, the board background image. You may already have seen it in some of my previous videos. So the point of this feature is to be able to overlay the typical board view you use in OpenBoardView with some pictures of the board you actually have on your desk. So it's much easier to spot components. So for example, if we are gonna want to look for U3900, I search U3900 and automatically I can see on the board that it's on this side and it's a big chip under here, which is T1 in fact. And same goes for other chips. And similarly, if we want to take a look at where does PPBus G3Hard goes, you can search for it and quickly identify components where it goes. For example, it's those resistors over there. And some caps over there. Of course, you have both sides of the board, and one major difficulty with this feature is to actually line up the board view correctly with the pictures we have taken. So as you can see on this picture right there, you can see that the board outline doesn't match perfectly the picture. So when you are gonna take some pictures of a board, you will often have a very hard time to get a straight shot without distortion, especially if you are using some lower end phone camera or something, you will always have distortion on the outer edge of the picture, so it will never line up properly. That said, even if you are not 100% lined up properly, as we can see here, can still help figuring out which component is where. So it's easy to see that this connector on the board view is this connector on the board, and you have a series of resistors right here that matches the resistors over there. So this board picture hasn't been taken by myself because I don't have any touch bar boards, but you can find some pictures of MacBook boards on the LogiWiki page. So that's logi.wiki, made by Chris B. And some people contributed some MacBook Air pictures and some MacBook Pro pictures. So right now we are gonna take a look at the MacBook Pro pictures. So you have the list of pictures available on this wiki. And right now we were looking at the MacBook Pro 15-inch Touch Bar 2016, 80-00281. So you have these pictures right there, and for some of them you already have the configuration file to line up the board view with the pictures taken. So the configuration file is just a text file with some information right over there. You have to copy this text and place it in a file with the same name as your board view file but .conf at the end. So for example, if your board view file is 820-00281.brd, you are going to create a file called 820-00281.brd.conf, and inside it you are going to add the text you just saw. And of course on this page we have some other pictures. So right there you have some older MacBooks, pictures that I've taken myself with the configuration file as well. Some other Mac pictures. Okay. You have also some MacBook Air pictures. They don't have the configuration files with them. But if a configuration file is missing, you can of course create it yourself. So if we go into the file menu and the background image preferences menu, you have this pop-up right there where you can select the top image file so you can hit Browse and select wherever you want the top image file. You have the same for the bottom image file, and you can then adjust the offset, so X offset here and the Y offset there. You can go positive and negative. You can adjust the scaling, so horizontal scaling and vertical scaling, and you can also flip the picture horizontally or vertically. So you will often find that you have to flip horizontally the bottom image picture. And you can also, if you want, adjust the transparency. So for example, you can adjust the transparency of the picture. And then you can hit save to save the new configuration file. And it will be saved, as you saw previously, with this name. The wiki I just show you is in fact a public wiki for the community. So you can register and edit the pages. So you can add your own pictures of MacBook, because there are a lot of them missing or with some quality issues. And then you can also add the configuration files for them. Of course, it's not only limited to MacBook board view. You can also use the same feature with Asus, MSI, Compal, Contour, and whatever boards you want. However, the wiki you see here is mostly dedicated to Apple products. So if you want to share some pictures for other brands, you can always do so on Badcaps. You have the laptops, portable and mobile devices, and you can send your pictures over there. It will be much appreciated. Okay, another feature on this new version, which is less important but still useful nonetheless, is the keyboard preferences features, where you can add your own key bindings. So you have some default key bindings that may not fit your keyboard layout or what you're used to in other software. So you can change these bindings. So for example, if I want to change the toggle pin binding, I click X to remove the binding, and then I can click Add to add a new key binding, and I can change it to whatever I want. So for example, I can press whatever key I want to add a different binding. If I want to have Control and zero, I hit Control and zero, and now my toggle pins binding is Control zero. And of course, you can see you can add many bindings, as much as you want, in fact. So that's it, and I would be happy to have some feedback on this new DB release. You can download it on the GitHub page of OpenBoardView. So that's github.com/openboardview/openboardview. You go into releases, and you will see the 8.95.0 release. It doesn't appear on the main page directly because this is a pre-release, it's not a final release yet, there might be bugs. And of course, you can report those bugs in the issues page. You can create a new issue, put some title and a description to report the bugs of the new release, and they will be fixed as much as possible for the final 9.0 release. And if you want to contribute to OpenBoardView, you can also do so if you are a programmer by forking the repository, doing your contributions, and then sending a pull request in the pull request page. So thanks in advance for your participation.